Section 7, Counting Zeros and Open Mapping Theorem. Theorem: let G be a region and let F be an analytic function on G with zeros A1, A2, etc. repeated according to multiplicity. If gamma is a closed rectifiable curve in G which does not pass through any point AK, and if gamma is homologous to 0, then 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma f dash z by f of z is equal to sigma k equal to 1 to m n of gamma a k. That is, we have given g is a region and f is an analytic function defined on g with zeros a1, a2, etc. am. Counting multiplicities. Counting multiplicities or repeated according to multiplicity means A1, A2, etc. am need not be distinct. That is, there may be repeated zeros. That is, suppose that if f of z equal to of the form z minus 2 into z minus 2 whole square into z minus 3. Here, f of z has three roots, 2, 2 and 3. So, actually, 2 is a repeated root. But we are counting it as three roots. But they are not distinct. There is a repeated root 2. That is the counting multiplicities. So, and also we have given gamma is a closed rectifiable curve defined in G, and gamma does not pass through a case. Gamma zeros ilude pass cheyunnilla, and gamma is homologous to 0. That means n of gamma w equal to 0 for every w belongs to G complement. Now we have given that a1, a2, etc. am are zeros. Therefore, f of z can be written as z minus a1 into z minus a2 into etc. z minus am into g of z, where g is analytic and g has no zero. G of z not equal to 0 for every z in g. Now we take log on both sides of this equation. That is, log f of z equal to log a b means log a plus log b. So log z minus a1 plus log z minus a2 plus etc. plus log z minus am plus log g of z. Now differentiating this equation on both sides with respect to z, we get a log f of z, the derivative is 1 by f of z, and the derivative of f is f dash of z. That's equal to 1 by z minus a1 plus 1 by z minus a2 plus etc. plus 1 by z minus am plus g dash z by g of z. We have the function g dash z by g of z is analytic except at g of z equal to 0. But we have given that g of z not equal to 0 for every z in g. So g dash z by g of z is an analytic function. Because g is analytic, therefore g dash is analytic, and g of z never 0 in g. That is, g dash by g is analytic in g. Therefore, and gamma is also homologous to 0. Gamma homologous to 0 means gamma homotopic to 0. We have the result. Therefore, by Cauchy's theorem, second version, integral over gamma g dash by g of z dz equal to 0. Now, in this equation, we integrate this equation on both sides over gamma. So, we get integral over gamma f dash z by f of z dz plus integral over gamma dz by z minus a1 plus integral over gamma dz by z minus a2 plus etc. That is equal to plus etc. plus integral over gamma dz by z minus am plus integral over gamma g dash z by g of z dz. And this term becomes 0 from the Cauchy's theorem on second version. Then multiply with 1 by 2 pi I on both sides, we get integral over 1 by 2 pi I in integral over gamma f dash z by f of z dz equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma dz by z minus a1 plus plus 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma dz by z minus a2 plus etc. plus 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma dz by z minus am. So these are the definitions of index number n of gamma a1 plus n of gamma a2 plus etc. plus n of gamma am. That is, we can write sigma k equal to 1 to m n of gamma a k. On left side 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma f dash z by f of z dz. That is the proof of the theorem. Next we have corollary. Let f, g and gamma be as in the preceding theorem, except that a1, a2, etc. am are the points in g that satisfy the equation f of z equal to alpha. Then 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma f dash z by f of z minus alpha dz equal to sigma k equal to 1 to m n of gamma a k. And this corollary is just from the previous theorem. That is, we have given g is a region. Here f, g and gamma as in the preceding theorem. That means g is a region and f is analytic on g. That is satisfy previous theorem a1, a2, etc. am are the zeros of f of z. Shivada dinoru acceptation parayunnundu. That is, a1, a2, etc. am are the points in g that is satisfy the equation f of z equal to alpha. A1, a2, etc. am satisfies the equation f of z equal to alpha. That means a1, a2, etc. a1, a2, etc. am are the zeros of f of z in the zeros alla f of z minus alpha and the function de zeros are a1, a2, etc. am in the slack number two. And also gamma satisfies the same property in the previous theorem. That is, gamma is a closed rectifiable curve. Such that gamma does not pass through any of the points a1, a2, etc. am, and gamma is homologous to 0. So, by the previous theorem, we have if f is analytic and a1, a2, etc. am are the zeros of f of z, and gamma is a closed rectifiable curve that does not pass any of the zeros ak, and gamma is homologous to 0, then 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma f dash z divided by f of z dz equal to summation of the index numbers n of gamma ak. Here a1, a2, etc. am in this corollary, a1, a2, etc. am are not the zeros of f of z, but they are the zeros of f of z minus alpha. We have given that f of z is analytic and alpha is any complex number. Therefore, f of z minus alpha is also analytic. And the derivative of f of z minus alpha with respect to z is f dash of z. So, we can replace the f of z in the previous theorem by f of z minus alpha. That is 1 by 2 pi I integral over gamma. Derivative is f dash of z divided by f of z minus alpha dz equal to sigma k equal to 1 to m n of gamma ak. That is the corollary. Proof of the corollary is direct from the proof of the theorem. That is, we replace f of z by f of z minus alpha. Okay, thank you.